Hi. Yes. Is it or is it not? I don't know why.
Welcome everyone. This is Social Dissonance. It is a durational concert. I have to tell you something at first before I begin the introduction. 16 of you have been given some small pieces of paper with a question. So if after the introduction you decide you want to leave, please pass the question to someone else so that it remains inside this room. So as you can see, we are being filmed. The video is streaming online as we speak on Periscope, and tomorrow it's going to be uploaded on YouTube and on archive.org and shown in the screen over there for people to see during the morning. The concert lasts 1 hour until 7 o'clock. And we would like to ask you to stay for the whole duration. It is very important for a situation to be built inside the space, and people coming and going is very distracting. If, however, you decide to leave somewhere in the middle, of course you can do so, but we will ask you for a short feedback in order to learn from you and improve. So the acoustics of this room, as you might have noticed, are a bit unique. So in order for us to understand each other, it is very important to speak one by one, loudly and clearly. Something else more technical, you cannot use this door that you came from, or this one either. We can only use this door as an exit. If you want to enter back into the exhibition, you just go around through the cafeteria. And one last thing, the curtains are a bit fragile, so please let's try not to drag them or destroy them in any way. And now you can leave your staff if you want, anywhere, and you, move a little bit into the space. Mm-hmm.
group or from another day, and they are written for us, for this group, for the today's group, in order to be helped and to try, they try to help us achieve the collective subject, the collectivity inside the space. So after they did this concert, after they participated, these were questions that they wrote that they thought they would be helpful. So anybody can start, but at the same time, as one person gives an answer, we can also think about the answer and the question also the other way.
Understand the rest. Everybody can answer?
No.
Is that what you meant?
No. But everybody should also think of their own answers.
Okay.
Do you really want to be a collective?
Collective.
I think we want to collect.
Two questions, I'd take both, or will my paper allow two questions? I take one or
both?
The first was, do you have a dream? Yes? So. And the second was, what do you think would be a nice hour here in this room? Can be like this. We'll see.
What would you like to do right now, even if you're too afraid to do it in front of the public?
To express my feelings of all I have seen today and I'm going to see here.
And I'm looking for a gesture which could explain this.
Would you like to be silent, not to talk for 1 hour? Yes, I like it. because I think too much times there are too much noises of bombs and others, and every event needs too much noise to be presented. And so I liked it, the silence.
In which direction do you want to guide us?
How would you want to spend it? What would you want to do with these people? I also, my first response is also that I want to be guided, or that I would need some framework to decide what would be the thing I want to do. But another thought is that I would like to sing together, because I love singing together with people.
I have the same question. Do you really want to be in a collective? I think yes, I do. But one where we establish the terms together.
What did your expectations look like? My expectations don't look like anything. The expectations that I have or that I'll be able to figure out what the next expectation might be and not try to plan too far ahead.
What do you feel comfortable doing together with people you don't know? I would say just most common things, like eating out, dining out, just for the fact that if there's really no common topics, there's still food to talk about. Just doing something that experience together, that is too people unknown can still comment on the same thing and maybe get a conversation going.
Sharing a food becomes communion.
What do you expect? I really expect nothing when I come to this room.
Can we include the people watching online into the group?
Sorry?
Can we include the people watching online into the group? I don't think we could include people watching, because not watching at the same time, and they don't share the atmosphere in this room.
Just ask them.
People, yeah. Would you like to be in the group?
Too late.
Yes, I can feel the energy, says someone. Yes, I can feel the energy. So what is this energy?
Do you want to form a collective subject and why? I don't know. I'm not sure if I want this. But singing is a good idea.
I have a question that I don't really understand, so I can read it out, but I don't understand the question. How can you be faster in the presence of the moment? How can you be faster in the presence of the moment? It's a philosophical one. I don't understand the question. Maybe somebody else understands the question.
It's very close to fasten also, which would have meant to stay, to put yourself here, you know?
How can you?
It's faster though.
It's not really clear. Mm. Faster, fasten, fasten.
It feels like some kind of tension between the immediate and the resistance of time. Speed versus something that you can't measure. Like the moment, the minute you say it, it's over.
But we have a camera, and every time this video we play, the person, if you address the camera and you speak about the exact moment, this is gonna play on repeat, so it's gonna speak about every individual moment in the future also, which is gonna be present for the people who watch it.
This is, how does a collective subject listen? I think this person's, you can listen with all your senses, not only with your ears, but speaking, looking, moving. Sort of speaking and listening. Even to your own senses.
front of people I don't know is to suggest the terms. Suggest the terms. You know, you use the word term. Maybe one of you used the word structure.
You don't want to suggest.
I'm aware of my self-consciousness in front of a room of people I don't know. But I don't want to be the one to suggest the terms. Shall we sing? Shall we be silent? Shall we touch? Shall we move? Shall we dance? Shall we all do something different? And now I feel embarrassed that I've tried to suggest the terms. Right. You can move on.
Where to?
There's like initiators in the room. Maybe we are here. We volunteered to help you research something that you're trying to research. So maybe you want to use us, like to help you research that.
We're trying to interpret this core.
Everybody know that we're trying to
improve
this score.
You
of something to do when you don't know the people you are with. But on the other side, it's also like a way to get to know somebody is to like do something together. Like somebody said, also like if you do something over a meal, for example. Mm-hmm. But now, like he said, like if you get to know somebody over a meal, then it's more easy because then you have the same experience. Now we just had this empty room. I can't remember where my sentence started.
A technical question on getting to know another person is, well, what do you do?
Yeah.
Who cares? It's how are you living and being?
Yeah. But it's also, what did you say? How are you?
Pardon?
What do you do? And but you said.
Yeah. What do you do? Is a typical question.
Yeah.
Or what is your title?
Yeah.
So
what is your title?
What is your title? Or what do you do? Is a typical opener.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's for outside of this room.
Mm-hmm.
That's for outside of this room.
Right.
Yeah.
That's right. Mm-hmm. It's doesn't matter. In the first 2 minutes.
Suggest singing would be good.
No, she suggested it.
Oh. Someone suggested singing. No.
And then it was me. But yeah, but it can also be sometimes when you think that something is nice, it can also be awkward, and it can the thing that can put you together as a group can also separate you if. If it feels too unsafe, then it doesn't bring the collective feeling you wanted to do. So, yeah.
expression, to make an expression, to make an individual noise, then singing a melody.
Yeah, that's
so
everyone
can.
That's nice.
Good acoustic, yeah. But it's sometimes it's difficult to understand the words.
Feels very hard because I can often get ideas of like social experiments that would be fun to do, but but when you're a child you do it, it's like the thing, you do it all the time. You do what? Social experiments. And you also like practice being a leader of the your thing, like, and then it's one leader and you and then you maybe change being a leader and
I don't think I relate to a lot of what's written. Like I don't accept a lot of these definitions.
Yeah.
So it's really hard for me to I don't know what does it mean, the collective subject. I mean, I would like to understand what is the intention behind that term. And also I don't know if I completely agree with this dichotomic definition of individual narcissism, and that capitalism promotes that, and that we are instrumentalized, or this very like, I don't know, there's a lot of things that can need to be discussed before kind of like approaching these bombastic terms, you know, like collective, a good, for me, a good first question is, what are we getting in a collective for? Like, do we have like actually something that we want to do together? Maybe not. I mean, we are here, I think we all volunteered here for a lot of different reasons. So maybe we will not all form a collective in this specific moment.
But we have a collective experience and we all committed to stay for 1 hour. So, and this structure has some basic characteristics we can talk about.
not really, I mean, maybe it's more in the yeah, actually, it's true. I mean, also being in a bus together with some people for a bus ride, that's also a collective experience, I guess.
Yeah, but they don't talk about the experience they had.
But we are supposed to talk about this specific, yes. That's the question. Like,
yes.
So we are supposed to reflect on this specific current experience of being in the group, like.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like being in the purgatory. But I too am annoyed by the text.
Mm.
Why?
I feel it is in the way of us creating a more authentic collective experience because we've been given a script to interpret that does not feel like the questions that we may have all come. This is not why I stayed. I stayed because there was this opportunity. I didn't want to do this, but I overcame my dislike of to stay with you.
I didn't read anything.
But now, what do you think?
I think it's a difficulty, it's a free form. It's a free form.
Someone asks here why you dislike the score. Why you don't like the score?
I don't like the score as a way to prompt a collective. When people began to speak, I almost wanted to cry a couple of times. When someone, I won't point at you, but just something about who you were as your fragile selves, just speaking up. And this I find very cold and distancing and alienating rather than something to. It's a series of ideas. It might not even be that it is about the ideas. It's about that this feels very aluminum, and this feels very skin.
Perhaps there's such a hidden agenda in the way this is put together and written. You say, oh, come on, we're supposed to say something that you want us to say based on this script, even though it may not be what we really believe or think.
Are we not alienated between each other here? Doesn't it feel like that we are alienated? Or I feel it like that? I'm the only one that feels that we are kind of alienated here. Alienated. Yeah, I feel alone. I feel that everyone is in its own head. Would you like to give it?
No, I wouldn't actually.
Does anybody else want to keep the camera?
No, but like, for example, if the camera was, for example, let's say we agree on the fact that there is a camera.
Okay.
That was not like, I mean, that was like the condition for that. But let's say if the camera was like standing alone and then everybody would be, I think there is like, you know, with group dynamics is so subtle. You really need to form
very specific conditions for something to emerge. You need to be hypersensitive to what is really, like, you know, sensitivities of different people in the group. And I think that bringing this element in changes the dynamics already. So
part of our everyday experience somehow. I feel it's,
yeah, I agree.
Skype, all this, yeah, we all use them, no?
Our own conditions, yeah, if you use Skype, or even though it's more video cameras, people are being more and more cautious of being filmed by other ones than oneself, I think.
Okay.
So we are more used to cameras, but we are also more critical to who are filming them and where it's going to be shown and who is watching it and if they record it, and because you can say that the situation is happening here and now, and also where people sit and watch, and also it's going to be screened here tomorrow, but it can also be duplicated and recorded. And I think this sense is like also, or this is different from the way when we think we have like our private photos or our private Skype sessions or stuff like this. Yeah.
But interestingly, looking back, when we started this process, we were all scattered throughout the room. And look at how tighter and tighter the circle is getting. Yeah. It's almost like we're the cameraman and we're together all the time. We're staging our own rebellion.
Maybe this is also a formation. Everybody's used to being in this similar type of situations, yeah? Where it's like, okay, somebody starts saying something, and then usually you're either sitting around the table in a group doing some project or something like this, or standing or sitting in a circle. Maybe if it gets like awkward long enough, then people will like, okay. this is the only way I know how to deal with like this awkwardness or this like sense of, tension.
Also, we couldn't hear one another when we were.
Of course. Yeah, I think this is why people, or it looked like that was why people were coming together, but then suddenly now it was just like you said, yeah, just like almost a perfect circle.
Everyone on the outside.
Yeah.
Does anybody think that the questions in the beginning helped at all? for us to do something collective.
Say that again.
Do you feel, does anybody feel like the questions were helpful?
Everybody follows each other and everybody is like answering pretty short, and then it was everybody was answering kind of short from the questions, so it didn't really it was just like reading the question and then answer, and then it was still this open space, and when the questions were finished it was still this open space with no rules, like,
with no
structure.
Can we see the difference between answering the questions now and before? If there's gonna be any difference.
Okay.
Do you think it's gonna be any difference if we try to answer the questions now?
If there's gonna be any difference if we try to answer the questions now?
We could try.
About the social sculpture documenta, boys, and so on.
Yes.
And this is
yes.
Kind of, but different.
Yes.
But the question here is, do you want, want is in capital letters, to form a collective subject, and I'm not sure about it.
Yeah.
I don't know what it, like what does that mean? What does it mean, a collective subject?
I don't like the singularity of it. Like that it, I don't like that it's in singular. Like, I don't like the fact that it's a collective subject, like, as if we are all supposed to become, like, a one thing together, where, like, it doesn't really leave a lot of space for multiplicity and, like, differences and kind of, I don't know, navigate it towards...
Really?
It doesn't really leave it towards something more, like, flexible. It feels very monolithic, this term, like collective subject. I mean.
Well, your fantasy, what you stand behind, or really this term?
I mean, I think it comes like subject, just this idea, like subjectivity somehow, as if it's something that is, you know, singular, whereas it's, I really believe that it's like a multiplicity of things, like, you know, collective.
Very diverse, very something which has very lots of colors, lots of intentions, and just shaping to go into a direction where every color is can be seen, or it is one shape, everything it's one uniform. Something this is very. It's not meant in a collective subject, is it? Or
collective and subject are both singular words, and so this is why it's you know, you could maybe say collective subjectivities. I don't know. I'm just saying that. I'm just
I don't know, just like thoughts. Very interesting that I don't remember exactly which one pointed out that they lacked in the beginning the way the questions were asked and the space was remaining open. But I feel like we cannot navigate ourselves through this undefined open space, and we are finding it very difficult to engage, and maybe we are afraid. I feel a bit afraid. I felt like I wanted to speak many times. But I felt that also, maybe because someone said in the beginning that they would like to be guided, and I felt like if I was engaging more than other people, it would be like taking this role. And of course the fact that we three are here before all of you arrived would give us a kind of power that would not, I think would not help towards any kind of collectivity. But at the same time, I feel like the fact that we gave the questions in the beginning and we said that the person that has the question should answer it also, might have led to that situation, because all of us were kind of isolated, answering by ourselves, and there was no dialogue. And I felt like it was very hard to escape that kind of structure that everyone expresses for themselves.
It was also because this was the question, yeah, which direction you want to guide us, which was like already implying that this was going to be my, since I got this card, this was going to be my thing, or task.
Your job.
My job, yeah. to guide us in some direction. I was like, I don't know why I would do that, or what that would help. Because it helps to like speak in some way, because other people speak. Yeah. Or you open like a little bit with this. Mm-hmm. But yeah, but also when we're like here for 1 hour, or like what, I don't know what is like best, to be silent or to talk, or if we like figure out something. We'd ask each other like, okay, what do you do? And then we would know that, and then it would be like, okay. Or would this be interesting to know what anybody is doing, or would it be more interesting to just like be silent and just like everybody sitting like feeling a bit tense? I don't know.
Nobody wants to dominate, nobody wants to be dominated, then the only thing we do is discuss the problem.
Maybe also the fact that we started with the questions directed the whole concert to this conversation procedure, trying to figure out why we got these questions, why we gave these answers, and what we're doing here, and all this frustration sometimes leads to action and sometimes leads to conversations that try to solve this frustration from a conversation. But what I find always interesting when we have this talk about the collective subject is actually what you said about, and also three of the questions said also that, if we want to form a collective and why. And actually, I don't have an answer, of course, but it's interesting that many times it has been mentioned that in order to form a collective subject, you've got to have a common goal, or a common interest, or a common thing between the group, that we all want to go towards a specific direction, blah, blah, blah. And I'm not sure about that. I mean, maybe we need a common goal, of course. People, when they have a common goal, come together easily. But maybe also the collectivity as a feeling, yes, not as a collective subject exactly, because it would be, there would be no actions in this subject, but also here I don't know exactly what kind of actions we could take in an hour. So maybe it's just the collective feeling that we could achieve, and this, I don't think that we need a reason to try to achieve it. I think that maybe, yeah, it feels good anyway.
I'm observing that because suddenly my brain clicked in for a moment when you started talking about Documenta and Joseph Beuys and this being a social sculpture, and my brain kicked in a more interested way about the structure. I suddenly became more interested because I remembered why we had Documenta. Mm-hmm. And then with the airplanes, when the airplanes began to be made, the counter, you know, the making of a thing in the same space as the shaping of a set of conceptual ideas. I'm now just thinking, I really like that both things were happening in the course of our struggle. That, I mean, you even talked about eating, so that's more like a thing than a conversation. But so I just offer that on the form of our collective questioning, I like that we were striving to do both things. I'm not sure we got anywhere, but you began to make.
Yes, but it was not so good. Yeah. If somebody knows to make a better one, I would like, because I have forgotten how to make a good one. So I was hoping maybe this thing would happen when you started making, and I would try to make it, then somebody would like, that I actually remembered how to make a really good one. Yeah. Because I've forgotten it, and I really want to learn it. But it would be nice with some clay or something like this, or something like Lego or something.
We had this onerous piece of paper.
We should have started, when you started criticizing it, maybe just like tearing it a little bit off and maybe cutting it up and putting it together in different ways.
Well, I like what you say. I like this form of simultaneous actions happening. I can understand what you mean. It was nice. I like what she said. This simultaneous actions when you were folding the airplanes and we were talking. I like this, but why sticking to something? Well, we can discuss why this airplane didn't fly. Really, there are technical problems we have to solve. So, of course, it makes worth talking about in the next 20 minutes. But why don't we take this? I enjoy being here and trying to figure out what it makes for you. Just going on a meter surface and thinking about it. Why? I don't want to solve this problem,
right.
But I don't mind if you both do it. What will you going on? You see, it's luxury. It's something very great. Just being, even if we don't know what to do.
I mean, if we got beyond that superficial answer that we all give, like, I wanted to see what would happen. But if we all got very deeply inside the question, why did you stay?
Me.
Me too. Me. All of me's. Why did we stay?
Yeah.
I don't think it's as as superficial as we might throw out to the group. Mm-hmm. We might like to know what would happen, but mm-hmm. I'm not ready to tell my reason. but that would be a common goal. Why did we stay? Why are we in this room together now?
Or another way of saying that is, why am I so different that I didn't walk out the door?